Hey guys, I'm gonna give you my March of 2017 Meniere's disease update. Oh yeah, we are on. We are rolling, rolling, rolling. Hey guys, it's Kelly from Chronic Illness Reality, and it is time for me to give you an update on my Meniere's disease. It has been 3 months, I can't believe it. I was talking to you about getting my third gentamicin injection the last time we talked, and if you follow my vlog channel with my husband, which is called Our Chronic Dance, you might have seen a little bit about what's been going on with me Meniere's-wise, so you might know a little bit more. So I'm going to give you an update here anyway. If you are interested in seeing the day that I got the gentamicin injection, you can go ahead and click on the link up here to the vlog. It's not going to actually show you the injection part, but it's going to show you before and what happened afterward and basically the whole day. So I did get the gentamicin injection, and I have since seen my neuro-otologist. I just saw him recently. And I learned that my reaction and my response to the gentamicin is so much different than what is typical and average for gentamicin response. So I wanted to clear that up at the get-go because I didn't know that it was abnormal. I want to make sure you guys know what my neuro-otologist, anyway, believes that the typical response to a gentamicin injection would be. So a typical response would be that after getting the injection through the eardrum, that a person would be affected by it within 1 or 2 days, and then would go through the whole process of, yes, being affected by vertigo and being affected by disequilibrium issues, and then within about 3 to 4 weeks should have recovered from that vertigo disequilibrium issue that's caused from the gentamicin injection. And you might have had to, some people have had to learn how, relearn how to walk. My very first gent injection, I didn't have to relearn how to walk, but the last two I did. So, you know, it can be different for everyone. He said he's had about 5 people similar to my experience happen. So my experience was that after the gentamicin injection, it took 9 days for the gentamicin to kick in. And then it took more like 8+ weeks, even up to the vertigo is okay, but then the equilibrium I'm still having issues with, and we are 3 months out. So that is not good. That is not the way it's supposed to go. But that is what has happened with me. And that's kind of why I didn't give you all as many updates as I had promised in the December video, because I realized that things were different than what he said it was going to be. And I didn't want to put out my experience as though it is the way it's supposed to be, because everybody's experience is different, and my experience seemed to be very different. I just saw my neuro-otologist, and I'm really glad I did ask him questions and really pressed him on some things, because I found out that something huge that I cannot wait to share with you guys. I probably am going to share it within the next week on my vlog channel. I'm going to be posting soon about my neuro-otologist appointment. My vlog channel doesn't happen daily usually because of my health, and I can't get things out every day. I have a lot of health issues, and so once I get that vlog up about the day that I went in to see my neuro-otologist about 1.5 weeks ago, then I will be posting a video for you guys. If you have Meniere's disease, I want you to check out this video because it's really important. It's something that I did not know, and I think it's important for everyone who has Meniere's disease to be aware of. So check that out. I also asked my neuro-otologist about why do we have to get repeated gentamicin injections, because the gent helped me for 4 months the first time, and then the second gent I had helped me for 6 months. And I said, do the nerve cells in the vestibular part or the balance part of our ear grow back? I mean, why does this happen? Why is it that I have, you know, help for a random amount of time and then all of a sudden I get vertigo again? And he basically said to me, Kelly, honestly, we don't know. The problem is that there just isn't enough research to know for sure what is going on. And that is so frustrating. It's so frustrating. And you guys and I live it out all the time because there aren't really very many good treatments for Meniere's disease. You know, legitimate treatments. I know that there are some people who promise cures. As far as the legitimate treatments, you know, whether it be Western or Eastern medication or, you know, just alternative complementary therapies, you know, those things can help a lot, even, you know, adjusting our diet and things like that. But as you know, if you get to this place where you're using gentamicin or you're considering surgery, you know that there just aren't very many. And of course, if you're bilateral, you're really aware of that. So, oh, my light went out. Sorry. Oh, well. So I really want to encourage you guys to not give up hope, whether it be in the United States or whether it be in other countries. We all need to encourage research. We all will benefit around the world from having more research. Finding out what's causing Meniere's disease will be the big thing that will help us. And so, yeah, I wanted to make sure I mentioned that. What was really great about this last gentamicin, even though I have had some problems with it, is that it did stop my vertigo. It did stop the Meniere's attacks. So as the other two gents had stopped it, this one stopped it too. So I was really, really happy about that. But the problem was is that when I was up and starting to walk, my balance never improved. It really has, some days I'll have better days than others, but it's just been really, really wonky. And that has been really frustrating. At first I thought it was vertigo, but my husband pointed out to me how I would react much differently to vertigo than I would react to the balance issue. He said with the vertigo, oh, I would just be so miserable. And not saying that the balance issue is a fun issue to have, but I would take the balance issue over vertigo every time, because the vertigo, as you all know, is just such a difficult, challenging symptom, horrible symptom to live with. Whereas the balance, it does affect my walking. I have to be very careful because I've fallen. I'll go ahead and put a link to one of my vlogs where you can see me walking. You can see the balance issues that I'm having. It's very strange for me to see it. It's even stranger to live, but I'm glad that it's not vertigo, because I was really concerned that the gent hadn't helped, but it has. And when I think about it, I'm like, oh yeah, I have been having vertigo that is related to my migraines. And then I am doing something that will hopefully help with the disequilibrium, and that is vestibular rehabilitation. I have been through it before. If you aren't familiar with it, a physical therapist usually does this, and it's if you're having issues with vertigo and or balance issues. So I'm gonna go and see a physical therapist who actually specializes in it. You wanna make sure if you go and have vestibular rehab, you don't just go to any physical therapist. You wanna go to someone who actually specializes in it. And actually, the one I'm going to go to only does vestibular rehabilitation. And so you kinda wanna find someone like that. Usually a neurotologist will have links to someone who only does vestibular rehabilitation. So I will be doing that. And like I said, I have something huge I am looking forward to sharing with you guys. It's a little bit hard for me to share, and so I hope you guys will support me because I feel very vulnerable in sharing it. But I am glad to be sharing it with you, because if it helps just one other person, I will be very happy. So thanks for supporting me. I am so happy that you guys have been along with me for my journey and allowing me into your journeys with Meniere's disease. I've learned so much from you guys, and I'm so thankful. If you're new around here, please comment on this video or any of the Meniere's videos and share your story. I would love to hear all about what you've been through. And if you have any sort of treatment that you're trying, I know some of you have told me, oh, I'm about to try this or I'm about to try that. Come back and tell us how it goes. Even if it's not successful, we'd at least like to hear how it goes, because all of us who have Meniere's disease would like to know about it. And even if it doesn't work, you know, you never know. We would all like to be educated on that. So thank you guys so much for being there. I am so appreciative of you, and you make me feel like I am not alone in my journey, and I'm so like I said, thankful to you for that. And remember, you are not alone. Update from March of 2017. What is that? So basically, the injection goes in the inner ear. So it's through also, no, it doesn't. This sticks.